So today we're talking about the goddess Ma'at because we're in Ma'at season. Ma'at is the goddess of divine order, truth, and justice. And she has 42 principles that are laid out of in the Egyptian Book of the Dead. It's 42 principles that constitute how it is that we're supposed to live as humans on the earth. The 10 commandments in the Bible are derived from the 42 principles of Ma'at. She is the female counterpart to Jehuti, who is the voice of Ra. There are 42 deities. We call them Neteru, the Neter. So Neter is the ancient Kemetic word for God. And there were 42 original gods in the story of creation. The African story of creation constitutes 42 gods. And they all play a part in the creation story. So it was more than just let there be light. And the burst of light was a part of that whole creation process. But the African creation story scientifically also gets into the way that the light came about and the beginning, what happened before the light. So it is a step-by-step telling of how everything came to be. And it goes beyond that. It goes into all of the layers that came, the four elements, you know, fire, water, earth, and air, and how those were built, how those elements came about. And all of those elements, they are represented by a god. So each god represents an element. And then it's not just as simple as the four elements. There are elements within those elements that are also represented by specific neter or gods. And that then brings about how it is that we came to be. So within those 42 gods, or 42 neter, we have the top three, which will be Ra, who Ra is represented by the sun. He is ultimately the father. In Southern African spirituality, we refer to Ra as Ramasedi, Om Vilingani, Ukamata. In different languages, he's referred to by different names, but he's ultimately the same God, and God is ultimately the sun for us as Africans. Ra then splits, not necessarily splits into two, but then they're the two descendants of Ra who then serve different purposes because Ra is the overseer. Then Jehuti, there's Jehuti who then we know of as Thoth in Greek mythology, but Greek mythology is taken from Kemetic science, who then is the voice of Ra. And then we have Ma'at, she brings order and she represents order and justice. And she is there also in the story of creation. Her purpose is to bring order to all of the, because creation has its point where it's quite chaotic. If you think about your creation process as well, just as a creative person, there's first the brainstorming element of creation, which is just kind of sporadic and chaotic. And then there has to come a point where there's a settling of all of those energies and all of those ideas that are going on in your mind to be able to form before then you can actually manifest those ideas. Then there's the manifestation process. So Ma'at is that energy that brings all of that chaos together to create a foundation for manifestation. So Ma'at is a leveling energy. She is the balance. She represents order. That is her principle. Her principle is order and her function is structure. So she brings structure to everything. The way to make the best use of her energy in this time is to really focus on your long-term plans and your goals. So really get into what is it that you want to build for your future? What is the foundation that you want to lay for your future? Like, this is a really good time to think about those things, to plan for those things. She's a really good energy to tap into for long-term planning, for bringing order into your life. Her energy really supports that kind of thing. So if you find that during this time, you're naturally thinking about your future and how to invest, how best to invest your time, your money, your energy, because remember, your energy is a currency, your time is a currency. Those are the biggest currencies before money even comes into play, because those are the things that you can never get back. You can never take your energy back. You can never take your time back. So you really need to make sure that you are investing those things the best way possible in the ways that are going to benefit you the most. And when you're looking into how to do that best, you tap into the energy of Ma'at, because that is the energy that actually empowers you to make the best decisions for your future, like long-term planning. If you're really, really looking to invest, like, that is the best energy to get into, to understand what are the best investments for you for the future. So there's no need to be anxious in the season. This is the best season to actually find balance and find order and find structure. And when we talk about balance also, she is also represented by the scale. It's quite a popular thing that we know about, that, you know, when you're passing, journeying into the afterlife, your heart is weighed on a scale. The origin of that concept comes from the Hall of Ma'at. The belief of our ancestors is that death is not the end. That's why mummification was such a big thing in ancient Egypt. They didn't bury the dead, they mummified them. And that was as a means to preserve their bodies, to help them journey into the afterlife. One of the places that you journey through when journeying into the afterlife is through the Hall of Ma'at. That is where you are judged and your heart is weighed on a scale against a feather. And that determines the way that you lived on earth, whether you fulfilled the purpose that you came to fulfill. If you treated others with kindness and you were fair and you basically adhered to the 42 principles of Ma'at, so that is the guideline as to how to live. That's basically what Ma'at is about. Ma'at season in the southern hemisphere is from the end of July to the end of August, so around the 21st of July to the 21st of August. So our calendar runs differently to the Gregorian calendar because our calendar actually goes according to the sun. So according to the celestial events and how we move around the sun, because our calendar is also very much in alignment with nature. And when we're in alignment with nature as people, then we are in alignment with spirit and with our bodies, and we're in alignment with the movement of the universe. And that's how we're best able to manifest and make best of the time that we have here. It's also how we're best able to optimize our health, our mental health, our physical health, our emotional health, and our spiritual health. So because our calendar is different, that means that, you know, also the way that we categorize our seasons is different. So for instance, our new year begins in September. Our new year is on the 23rd of September in Africa. Because of the way that our economy is set up, we do go by the Gregorian calendar because that is what is perpetuated on us by the Western system. But if we're looking back to our African roots and our African history and our indigenous African identity, our calendar is different and our new year starts in September, which is confirmed by nature because everything starts to bloom in September. That is when the spring equinox is, and the spring equinox brings new life. It brings everything greens, all the fruits and the flowers bloom, and that constitutes our new year. And, you know, so our calendar coincides with nature. We look at the equinoxes and the solstices and all of the celestial events. So when we're getting into the seasons, the movement of the sun then marks the ends and the beginnings of our seasons. The season of Ma'at then begins on the 21st of July, because the beginnings of our seasons actually end and begin around the 20th. From, I'd say, between the 20th and the 24th of each month is when we're transitioning into a new season. And so the season of Ma'at begins on the 21st of July, said a couple times, and it ends on the 21st of August, and that's when we begin to transition into the next season. So the season of Ma'at, there's so much that's happening that is significant to what it is that we are going through as people, not just as African people, but as people in the southern hemisphere, because of what's happening with us naturally in relation to the sun. Our spirituality as Africans is not based on a belief system, more as it is based on a knowledge system. It's about nature. It's about nature, how we interact with nature and how nature affects us. The season doesn't occur at a cardinal point, at one of the four major cardinal points, but it does occur in a very significant time because it comes after the season of Ma'at, comes after the season of Set, which is a very chaotic season. That's when things are likely to be corrupted, or that's when, you know, we're likely to be faced with issues of conflict, of corruption, of chaos, of disorder. And that is then the season of Ma'at then comes in to neutralize all of that energy, to balance out that energy. So there's different ways to also get into, to tap into the energy of Ma'at. There are physical ways that you can, there are physical tools that you can use to actually tap into that energy. one of the ways, one of my favorite ways to tap into deity energies is through crystals, because different deities are represented by different crystals, because crystals conduct energy and they give energy and they hold a certain type of energy. Each crystal holds a certain type of energy, and that's why scientifically oh thank you and that's why scientifically, you know, when you read about crystals, different crystals do different things. There's some crystals that like the serpentine, my favorite serpentine crystal, is good for helping your body absorb magnesium and, you know, different types of nutrients. And the amethyst crystal is the crystal that is good for tapping into Ma'at energy. This is I don't know how you pronounce it, if it's amethyst or amethyst, but I say amethyst. People pronounce it differently. This, it's a purple crystal. It's really easy to find. You can find it at any crystal shop. I think it's the most popular kind of crystal. It's purple. It represents the crown chakra. A lot of people use it for crown chakra work. There's different ways to use it, and you know, an easy way to use this to tap into your energy is just to wear it. Like, it's really easy to wear. You can find those like little, like they have those necklaces and crystal shops where you can just pop it in the middle and it hangs on your chest. And that's a really great way to tap into your energy and carry it with you. Just wear it every day, especially when you're doing that meditation or the setting of intentions. So, because this is a really great time to set intentions for your long-term plans. So this is a really great crystal to use. Just find yourself an amethyst and carry it around with you. You can also put it in your bra. Like, I'm that kind of person, like I'll wear a crystal, but sometimes, you know, if I'm working with different kinds of energies, I'll just pop them in my bra. Like, also a really great way to tap into her energy, if you're someone that's into incense is a really great way to center yourself. It's my favorite form of aromatherapy, besides essential oils. I really like to burn essential oils. If you are into incense, a great way to tap into her energy is to burn frankincense. That is the incense or the scent that represents Ma'at. So, and all of this is very scientific. If you want to understand it, a really good book that I recommend is called The Sacred Magic of Ancient Egypt. It really gets into the information on each deity, the African creation story, the principles and functions of each deity. It talks about the body parts, which body parts represent which deities and why. And it also will give you a really good understanding on how our ancestors understood the science of nature and how we can empower ourselves through the science of nature. So it's not a belief system, like I said, it is a knowledge system. They were able to turn substances like lead into gold. They were able to make gold. So there were things that they were able to do, things that we physically feel we're unable to do today because we've been so disempowered, because we've been taken out of alignment with nature. So the whole point of actually getting into, you know, people that are into this kemetic stuff is not just because it's cool or it's interesting or it's like, you know, like niche. It's because it's an actual science that empowers you. Like, if you're able to understand the African creation story and you're able to understand the deities and the science of the deities, that empowers you because it aligns you with nature. African science is about alignment with nature first and foremost, and that's all it's about. And once you're able to align with nature, you're able to make the most of the resources that you have at hand, that the universe presents to you, because it is all about universal energy. And when you're able to tap into that, like, the sky is literally the limit and the world is yours. Like, there's nothing that you can't do, because this life is ultimately about manifestation. And if you're able to manifest, then you're constantly going to win. Like, there's no losing. So in that book, I'm not gonna get into all of the different representations of Ma'at, because it goes on and on and on. Like, I could talk for an hour about all of the different representations of Ma'at. For instance, there's a specific tree that represents Ma'at. It's the papyrus tree. And ancient Egyptians used to use it to make different things. They would make cloth, sails, they would make paper out of papyrus. And the paper that they'd make out of papyrus was the chief writing material that was used in ancient Egypt, and it was taken and then later used by the Greeks, and then later used by the Romans, the Roman Empire. And everything in the Roman Empire was taken from ancient Kemet, which is why so much of the Bible is derived from ancient Kemet. Like, it's proof, everything is there. Like, it's really easy to identify all of the things that are in the Bible that come from ancient Kemet, which is why it's also really important to tap into ancient Kemetic energy, because it is the origin of all of the magic that is actually in the Bible, but, you know, is so hidden and difficult to tap into because it's just mixed in with a lot of things that also then don't coincide with nature. And so we're not able to tap into nature, into the magic of nature and the energy of nature just through the Bible. You actually really do have to go into the origin of these things so that you're able to tap into the energy, you're able to tap into the magic, and so you're able to make the most of the life that you're living. So my ultimate advice for the energy for the season of Ma'at: get you an amethyst crystal, get you some frankincense, light some candles, set intentions. Setting intentions is what you do to manifest your biggest dreams, goals, and desires. Setting intentions can be done through vision boards, simply writing things down. And then once you've written them down, it's up to you whether you bury them in the ground, whether you light them up, let the smoke rise into the sky. And that's your way. Whatever it is that you do, make sure that you do it with intention. Don't just do it, because magic is in intention. Also, I wanna say the color violet. So it's the color violet, the amethyst crystal, the frankincense scent. And then you can also find, you know, in the sacred magic of ancient Egypt, if you're interested in finding it, that will tell you a lot more different ways to tap into her energy and to make full use of her energy. This is what you wanna do if you really wanna set powerful intentions for your future and you want to manifest a fruitful and prosperous future. This is the way to do it. Like, I'm not kidding. This is what you want to do, because it will work. Like, it's absolutely guaranteed. So this is the time to set intentions for what you want for the future. Thank you for letting me talk about this weird stuff, and I hope that you get it, and I hope that it resonates, and I hope that, you know, you can use this to bring a little bit of magic and results into your life. If you would like me to make more videos on African history, African spirituality, African Kemetic history, and our deities, and aligning with nature, and how to align with nature, how to get into, you know, into understanding where it is that we come from, who we are, because it's really important to note that, you know, people, especially us in Southern Africa, we feel so disconnected from Egyptian history or anything to do with like the pyramids and Egypt because it's so far away. But what is really important to understand is that the civilizations that constituted ancient Kemet, you know, Nubia, Upper Egypt, Lower Egypt, all of those civilizations migrated from South Africa and from West Africa, and everything began in South Africa. Scientifically proven that the oldest bones in the world were found in Botswana. Everything originates from, like, Southern Africa is the heart of the world. It's the root chakra of the world. Like, that's where everything began. So we actually formed the civilizations that existed and that formed the greatest civilization of all time in Egypt. The Great Pyramids, everything that was built there, everything that was formed and solidified there, and all of the writings, like all of the history, the hieroglyphs on the wall, all of the literature that comes out of that place comes from the ancestry that began in Southern Africa. That's why those are our people, and that's why we are so connected to that energy. That's also why we have names for the same gods that they referred to and they spoke of, because we are the same, we're the same, and the magic that they knew is the magic that they got from us. So don't feel far removed from that, because that is who you are, and you have full entitlement over that information and that knowledge. It doesn't belong to the Arabs. It doesn't belong to white people. It belongs to you as an African person. And that's what we need to start getting into as African people, so that we can also reclaim our power and reclaim our energy and our magic and our land. Thank you for watching. I'm done.